Hey everyone, welcome to another Flaming Furnace video. So what I'm going to show you today is how I'm going to cast a solid aluminum coffee table. I'm sitting in my garden and there's one thing missing. I'm always sitting here and I'm looking for a place to put my coffee or beer. Now it's going to be sort of a dual purpose coffee table because I want to use it also in my sitting room and also outdoors. So it have to look a little bit semi-decent or else I'm going to have troubles with the lady. So I'm going to make it again, like always, from recycled material. I'm going to use drink cans in this case, but you can use other resources of aluminum. For example, car parts, you can go to any garage and just get yourself a scrap aluminum. That's actually a better source of aluminum for castings. But for this case, I'm just going to use aluminum cans because, as I said in previous videos, they're all over the place, you know, and I'm just going to show you something really cool that you can make out of them. So next time you walk down the street and you see that squashed can, just think about this coffee table. So my first video is going to be about how I'm going to make the top part of the table. I'm going to use a lot of material. I'm going to mostly make it out of MDF, but also different other accessories. So stay tuned for that. And probably there will be a second part for this video. I might do another one. I don't want to make it too long. Just how I'm going to cast the solid legs for the table. And the actual casting on both videos, that's I think the best part. So stay tuned. If you have any questions, just drop me a line below and like and subscribe. Enjoy. Okay, so this is going to be the top part of the table, and underneath that's going to be the base to sort of create an illusion of a thicker base and to give it a little bit more strength. So now I'm just gonna create a quick jig for the circle in the middle of the table. I'm gonna use my router for that, and I recommend use a dust extractor when working with MDF because it creates a lot of fine dust and it's really not healthy to inhale it. And that's gonna be used as the jig for the center of the table. What I'm going to do, I'm just gonna use the router to create a perfect center hole in the middle. Okay, so I decided where I want the letter to go on the top of the table. So I marked it on the MDF, and what I'm going to do now, I'm going to create another template, and this template is just gonna help me with the recess using the electric router on the top of the tabletop. So what I'm going to do now with this new jig that I just finished, I'm just going to put it on the top where I have the lines marked, and I'm going to create a very shallow recess, the same depth as the letters that I'm going to be using. So to make the recess, I just connected to my router the guide template, and I'm going to use that to create a shallow recess. Yeah, it is. So now I'm just gonna clean it up a little bit and move on. So yeah, this is just to give a general idea how it's going to look with the letters inside the recess. Okay, so what I did now, I just finished routing the edge for the top piece, and this is basically going to be attached to the bottom piece, and I'm gonna also route some sort of a shape here, either round or a 45 degrees angle. I haven't decided yet. Okay, now I am going to groove the base of the tabletop. So that's it, the main part of the tabletop is done. The two parts are going to be sitting on top of each other. Obviously I'm going to glue it together and clamp it, so it's going to be nice and tight. This is the angle that I created in the section that's going to be under the table. And again, the angle here is just to make it easier to take it out of the sand. If it's a flat angle, most likely the sand will break and then I'll just have a lot of casting defects. So the last bit is just to finish all the parts here and glue the letters into place, clean everything, and then put a bit of filler wherever it's needed, wherever I have the nail holes. And from there it's just to put a few coats of varnish on it and it will be ready for the sand mold. So one of the things that I just came across is this thumbtacks pack that I had here in my workshop, and I decided I'm going to put it all around the pattern in distances of 40 mil. Just again, I would recommend people that are, if they are doing similar thing, to drill the hole in the middle last, because again you can just take the center point and create additional markings on your template that will help you later on to position anything that you want to attach to it. So here, for example, if you want to put every 40 mil a thumbtack, you can just take the compass, mark it at the fourth point, and then go to the next point, so it's quick enough, and then you have exact locations where to nail every thumbtack. Now I'm going to use this flush bit with the bearing on top of it, and I'm just going to cut the center hole using the template that I created on the very base, and that will guide me to create the perfect hole in the center. The hole in the middle is centered, and you can see if you have a good template, you'll get the exact finishing that you want, dead center. This is the template on the top of the actual tabletop, and I use again the flush bit with the bearing, so I have to put it on the other side. I'm just going to remove the template now and show you how it looks. Okay, so this is how it looks after I removed the template and cleaned it up a little bit. I already start to use a wood filler to fill the recesses around the edges, just to make a little bit of an angle. Yeah, it looks a little bit like a smiley face. I really didn't intend it to look like that, but if I put two eyes here, yeah, it would be a perfect smiley face. Anyway, what I'm going to do now, I'm just going to attach the letters, start cleaning it up. I'm also going to create a bit of an edge around here with my electric router, and after that I will attach the base to it as well. Okay, so now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to use this bead with the curve, and I'm going to round it around the center hole, and again that's just to create a bit of a draft, a bit of an angle, so when I'm going to lift it out of the sand, it's not going to break the sand, and it's also going to be a little bit more attractive to the eye when it's going to be finished. So basically I screwed up the center hole. I didn't use a jig on the very bottom of it. This was a 80 mil, so I'm just going to run it again. This time I'm going to put this template underneath, so it should even out the hole. The hole is just going to be slightly bigger. Okay, so this is round two now. I'm going to try and fix the hole in the middle that I messed up. I made a slightly bigger jig. The previous one was 80 mil. This one is just 84 mil, so the hole is going to be slightly bigger. So now the hole on the top is perfect. However, I created myself another problem because I enlarged it, so it's bigger than the glass, so if I put the glass through it, it's just gonna fall in. So I'm going to use this part. It's from a car, it's just made out of plastic, but it's absolutely perfect size. I'm gonna just stick it on the bottom, and then here on the very top I'm just gonna put a filler in here and create an angle. So after about 2 minutes and the magic of super glue, the plastic is in place, and I'm going to just fill it up with a filler inside, create the angle in here, and that's it. The middle is going to be finished. Okay, so this is it. The center is filled with the fresh wood filler. I let it dry, and after that I'll sand it. On the back it's also sort of chamfered here, so I don't have to worry about any sand breaking. So now it's the point that I'm going to glue the tabletop to the support on the very bottom. I'm just going to use a wood adhesive for that. Okay, I'm gonna leave the glue to dry now for a few hours. After that, I'm just gonna continue with the details. I'm gonna put on the letters on the very top, and after that, varnish it, and that. Okay, so the two main components for the table are finished. This is the tabletop after about 4 or 5 coats of varnish. Now after every coat dried, I left it for about 24 hours to dry. But once it dried, I just sanded it with a very fine grit sandpaper just to get rid of all the little lumps and bumps that sort of stuck to it. So at the moment, it's really smooth. And then the finishing that you're gonna get in the actual aluminum casting is going to be very good. I can show you a similar item that I did in the past, in previous video. If anyone watched that one, that's a boat cleat. And I use exactly the same method, just to coat it with varnish. It's the same thing, it's just a split pattern made out of MDF. But the casting turned out very well, so I'm just trying to sort of replicate that process with the coffee table. And this is the leg. I did exactly the same thing. Now the leg I just did for now just 2 coats of varnish, so I'm going to give it 2 more coats and sand it a little bit. I'm just gonna open it now. This is the first time that I'm going to open it since I sort of varnished it and I used the filler. So just to see if it's gonna open easily enough. I'm just gonna try and grab it here from the side. Yeah, so it seems to be separating easily. So I'm not gonna separate it all the way. I'm just gonna give it 1 more coat of the varnish, but once that's gonna be done, as you can see, it's very, very easy to separate it and you have a perfect split pattern. So yeah, that's it. I'm almost ready for the casting. One more thing that I might do. I might attach 3 bits of MDF just where the legs are going to be connected to it for the bolts for a later on stage. I haven't decided yet what sort of attachment method I want to use here, but I think I'm just going to use bolts. So yeah, let's see how that's gonna work. Okay, it's time for the sand mold. I'm gonna start with the top of the table. I'm gonna use my large wooden flask for this. And the sand that I'm going to use is oil bonded sand, petro bond. Okay, now it's time to open the flask. Hopefully the sand is not gonna break. Absolutely perfect. Looks good. So yeah, next step, I'm just going to heat up my furnace now, get the aluminum ready, and the best part, the actual pouring of the molten aluminum. So the flask is ready for the pouring. Here is the ingot tray that I'm just gonna pour all the excess aluminum into it. And as you can see, all the aluminum is melted all the way to the top. So just one more ingot that I'm waiting for that to melt. I'm going to degas it and then I'm going to do the pour. And a bit of washing soda. Okay, another thing that I always do before I use my ingot tray is I preheat it for about 3 minutes. So all needs to be done is just to put it on top for about 3 minutes and then there's no risk of the aluminum popping out of it. Okay, so now I'm going to open the flask and see how the casting turned out. Let's have a look. Okay, I can see straight away that something went wrong with the casting. Apparently the sand collapsed inside. So as you can see here, there's a big blob of aluminium here. So this is unfortunately unsuccessful casting. So I will have to try and do this casting again. Yeah, that happens sometimes. Let's look at the other side. Yeah, so there was a big casting defect on this side as well, as you can see. It seems to be that the sand just collapsed inside the actual sand mold cavity, so it's quite a shame. There was quite a lot of work put into it, but sure, that's part of the fun. I'll just have to do it again and see next casting how it looks. Okay, so this is the second casting attempt. Hopefully this time it turned out well. It's still hot, but I'm really anxious to see how it looks inside, so I'm just gonna open it now and hopefully this time the casting turned out well. Still smoky. Try and open it. So it seems to be much better than before. The sand didn't break. Seems to be intact on this side. Get a bit of brush, brush all the sand off. So one side looks well. Now I'm just going to pull it out. So this is one side. Okay, so this side of the casting turned out very well. So that's a good start comparison to the previous casting. So this time we didn't have any collapse of the sand and it was intact. Now I'm just going to turn it around. Look at the other side. Seems to be intact as well. Successful casting. Here's just a closer look on both sides. That's just the back of the table top. This would be the top of the tabletop. Needs a bit of a polishing and cleaning, of course, but overall turned out very well. So yeah, I'm happy with this casting. Okay, so this is just a very quick overview of two castings. So this is the first casting. Unfortunately, it didn't turn out well. We got massive casting defects on the top and also on the back. So what happened, as I explained before, the sand collapsed into the sand mold and I just did the casting once again because I can't use this one. So this is the second casting and it turned out very well, very successful. The top of the tabletop is absolutely perfect. Just need a bit of a cleanup and polish. And the same for the back of it, absolutely perfect. So what I'm going to do next, I'm just going to cut off the gating systems and after that give it a bit of a cleanup. And then next part is to cast the aluminum legs for the table.